Section one of the book concerns entrepreneurship. How important, Paul, are SMEs to the economies of countries?
Well, I think we've got to get this really firmly into perspective. Most businesses on the face of this planet are small. However you define SMEs, 95% or more of companies in this world are SMEs. In the EU, they provide two-thirds of employment. And in the UK, we know if we can identify the fast-growing firms, they will generate more than 50% of the employment in the UK over the next 10 years. The problem, of course, is how we pick those winners.
And can governments influence how SMEs perform?
Well, certainly governments can't pick winners. They've got a long history of not being able to do so. But the major way that governments influence the development of SMEs is through their macroeconomic policy. By that I mean times of bust, times of boom. Those influence the growth and indeed closure of small businesses enormously. Things like the amount of red tape can influence the amount of time SMEs spend on that area enormously. So it's macroeconomic policies that influence the growth and development of SMEs.
And SMEs themselves, are they really, really different to larger businesses?
Chalk and cheese. Absolutely chalk and cheese. Big companies run by grey-suited people. An SME is two arms, two legs, and a giant ego. It is a person. It's a person, and the DNA of that person is stamped indelibly on the company, on the organisation. That's how they're different.
And you make the distinction between entrepreneurs and owner-managers. How exactly are they different?
I think, to summarise it, I think they're different in three important ways. Firstly, an entrepreneur is far more perceptive of opportunities. They're constantly scanning the horizon for opportunities. They see opportunities, they go out and take those opportunities. That's the first important difference. The second important difference is entrepreneurs are far more willing to innovate. They will do things differently in some way to other people. And that distinctive differentness is the thing that makes them money. And then the third important difference is, of course, they're willing to take more risk in doing that.
And finally, can training or education improve entrepreneurship?
Oh, this is an old question, isn't it? I'd ask you a question back. Can training improve the performance of an athlete? And the answer, of course, is yes, it can. But somehow, to start with, there's got to be that spark of athleticism or entrepreneurship there. That's got to be there to start with. You can then hone it, you can improve it, and indeed more than that, you can give them the skills to make their entrepreneurial bent actually work.